as we move along the year now, things are going to warm up, and that's when my float choice changes, because we're going to be fishing maybe bigger baits. We're going to be catching big weights of carp, big carp, where all your gear gets obviously hammered a little bit more, so you need stuff. It's not going to let you down. Also, really importantly, is main lines again. That's when I move up from like 015 to 017 to 019, even up to 021 main lines. And as we all know, it's not just about fishing on the bottom during the warmer months. It's obviously fishing in the margins and fishing shallow. And that is for carp and F1s, which I'm going to talk you through now because they're really, really important. And again, like I've done on my previous float video, is talk to you about shotting patterns. I think, honestly, when you start fishing shallow for carp and F1s, the shotting patterns are very, very similar, very, very simple. They don't change much at all, but I'll run you through them as we go. But one float that I do use, because obviously we spoke about my sort of all-round commercial floats last time, which is like the F1 maggot and floats very similar. But there's also a float in the commercial range called an inline diamond. And they come into play for me. People use them even during the winter months for carp fishing, but I use these now more when I'm going to sort of, if I was going to Whiteacres, Belinge, that's when these sort of floats come into play. Even Tobburn Manor and Viaduct and venues like that, when you're catching fish, you know, on the bottom with baits like bigger pellets and meat, they've got a bigger, thicker bristle, which you obviously need that. As we go into the summer months, you get a few more liners and stuff. You don't want to be striking it really, really tiny bites some days. So let's go into it. Again, nice and nice and simple little range. They go from 4B12 right up to 4B18s. So whatever depth of water you're fishing in, that little selection of inline diamonds will cover you. 4B18s, I'm not going to get a 4B18 off, but the shotting patterns are identical to my last little video that I showed you about the F1 maggots. So the 4B14, I will get one off, a 4B14. That one's actually tied on 019, which is like 8-9 pound mainline. So obviously it tells you that I'm going to be using these floats when I'm catching a lot more carp and bigger weights. Again, shotting pattern, absolutely identical. So you've got 3.5 inches, number 10s, because I'm using a 4B14, and then number 9s is a bulk. Now, again, that's whether you use shot or stots. It doesn't make any difference. So just keep everything simple. Keep it the same. So in your mind, when you're confident with something, it helps massively. And I'll just talk about these floats a little bit more, because they are different, like the F1 maggots. They've got a different stem. They've also got a different insert. Now, the stem themselves is actually made of fiberglass. Fiberglass gives you really, really good, it keeps the float stable. Fiberglass is sort of in between wire and carbon. It actually sort of pre-cocks the float, so they're very, very stable. Obviously the line there, they've got one of the eyes that you cannot break, so they're super strong. 2mm hollow bristle. So like I said, meat, corn, big pellets, big worms, baits like that, when you're fishing on the bottom, they are an absolute fantastic little float. You can't break them. I've had these floats for years and I've never broke one. They are absolutely ridiculously strong. But the line goes through the eye, but it also goes through the body. And as we go into some of the other floats that I use during the sort of summer bagging months, this is what we've designed to do, because the line then doesn't actually eat through the body of the float, which is obviously important. So that's the inline diamond. Like I said, they go from 4B18s right down to 4B12s. But the shotting patterns on the 4B14, 4B16 and 4B18 are the same. Apart from, I do move up slightly bigger droppers as I get on the bigger floats. So 4B18, I would have 2 number 8 droppers and number 8 as a bulk, because obviously we can only use number 8s because of the lead, obviously, in England, in Wales, in Scotland. 4B16, I would put 2 number 9 droppers on, number 8 bulks, and then 4B14, 2 number 10s, number 9 as bulk, and then the 4B12 will be exactly the same pattern, or I'm hoping it is when I take this float off, unless I've actually used it. It'll be the same as what I showed you on my previous video. So when I go down to 4B12s, I just stretch that little stretch the shot out over that sort of two and a bit foot. So on there, three number 10s, three number 9s. Job done. These floats, for me, when I'm fishing meat short, 4x12s in like 3, 4, 5 foot of water are an absolute must. When you're throwing meat or cad potting meat short, they are deadly. And that's why I've got that shot spread out a little bit, because I'll be flicking that past my pole tip and you'll be amazed how many fish you catch on the drop when you're fishing with meat and corn and even with hard pellets. So keep it nice and simple. The same sort of shot and pattern as what I showed you on the previous video. And as you go up in sizes, the droppers change and also the bulks change, because I don't want too many shot. So let's move on to one of my other favorite floats. So that's the inline diamond. Let's get him back on, otherwise I'll get in a right mess with everything. Another fantastic float, because we're sort of moving into sort of shallow water now, shallow water situations, is a float called a carp shallow. It's called a carp shallow. It's an all-round float, that. So that's got a fiberglass stem again, and it's got the super strong eye, and also the eye again after the eye. It's got a hole in the body where the line goes through and comes at the bottom, so it stops all the line from eating into the float. And when I tie these up, these are obviously tied up from 015 right up to 021, because they are about catching carp, especially during the warmer months. Let's get him off a minute so I can find the end. Let's get another one out because I can't find the end. So let's get him off of that winder. So that's a 4x12 version. These go from 4x10s right up to 4x16s, because these are the sort of floats as well. If you fish venues with, when you're fishing up against far bank and it's really deep, I can fish up to a 4x16. Literally a simple bulk during the summer when you're fishing short hook lengths with hard pellets. That's what they're designed for. They're quite a small float. They're probably only, actually, it's measuring, they're just over 3 inches long. So they're great for fishing in the margins. They're great for fishing over against islands. They're really, really tough and strong. Like I said, fiberglass stem. So they sort of semi-cock. So they're really, really stable. The actual carp shallow has got a slightly thinner bristle. That's 1.5 again, because they're an all-rounder. You know, you can fish shallow, you can fish against margins, you can fish for F1s and carp. And then on a 4B, that's a 4x12. This one's got stots on. So again, it depends whether you want to use shot or stots. Obviously, when I start fishing with real heavy main lines, stots are much, much better. You don't damage the line and they're really, really easy to get on and they don't come off, which is important when you're bagging. And I've just put them, what have I got on there? I've actually got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 number 9 stots. It's really, really simple. And I've just spread them out sort of 3 inches apart at the moment, and I can move them around in the morning. If I'm fishing up against an island and I want to just bulk it down, I can. That's the beauty about stots. You can move them about so easy. Bulk all them down like that. And then obviously as your session goes on, as your match goes on, you think the fish have gone a bit funny, I can just spread these about, get your stots 2 or 3 inches apart like that. And then I can sort of flick it around and maybe catch on the drop. So that's the carp shallow. It's an all-rounder, honestly. It's a fantastic float to fish, whether you're fishing, you know, down the margin. You can even catch carp shallow on that. I won't put him back on because it's going to take too long. I'll put him on in a minute. And then we do another float called an edge. Now, awesome little float. Loads of people use these during the summer. Again, it's a bit of an all-rounder, really, but it's got a thicker bristle. This has got I think it's 2 mil bristle. So it's a bit like the inline diamond bristle. It's a great float. Fiberglass again, so you can tell the difference. As we start going into the warmer months, fiberglass is mega, mega strong. The eye, again, you have the eye and also the line goes through the body on there, folks. But they're the same. They're like about 3, 3.5 inches long. So they're perfect for shallow, up to islands, down the edges. But they've got a thicker bristle. So if you're fishing with big baits like 10 maggots, big lumps of luncheon meat, double corn, big dendrobinas, you know, worms and things like that, that's what their floats are for. Heavy lines. I've got these tied to 019 and 021. because I know I'll be going to somewhere like Larford, fishing out down the edge, big carp, you know, need some up mega, mega strong. That's what them floats are all about. So that's the edge. And then we've got a couple of shallow floats, the inline dibber. I'm not going to get one of these off. These are designed basically, the line goes through the float, out to the bottom of the body, and straight to a bulk. And it is a simple bulk. The same with the edge floats. The edge floats will be shot up exactly the same as the carp shallows. They're identical. And I think they, what I remember, they go, the edge floats go in 4x12, 4x14s and 4x16s, because that's the sort of fishing you're going to be covering with them. Shallow water, up against, you know, in margins and up against islands or the far bank features. So anyway, let's go back to the inline dibber. Beautiful little float. Awesome. And these are just bulk down. Let me take you one off, because I think there's nothing better than actually showing what I do, because that's what these films are all about. And we don't lie on these films. We tell you how it is. This is what I do in my garage, day in, day out. So there you go. I've literally got three number 10 stots on there. That's how I make it up, because that's what I'm going to be doing with that float. I'll be fishing for F1 shallow with that float, 100%. You could fish with carp with it as well, but that float to me is when I'm bagging for F1s, feeding pellets, casters, maggots, even slop, you know, fishing with pieces of worm on the hook. You can fish these really, really shallow, and they don't tangle because the line goes down through the float like that. You can probably see that on the camera. They don't tangle, so they're brilliant for flicking over. You know, when you're flicking your rig over, trying to make a bit of noise and the fish come to the actual bait or the noise of the float going in, that's what's them about. They're an awesome little dibber, mega, mega strong, nickel titanium wire, so they're self-cocking, which is really important when you're fishing with a dibber. So let's get him to one side. I'll put them back on the winder in a bit. One of the floats that I've, years and years ago, is called a jigger. And there she is. There's a Preston jigger float on there. They come in two different sizes, so they obviously take two different weights. On their day, it's like when you're using that dibber float, if you start missing lots and lots of bites, you're really, really crafty to catch, have a jigger set up. It is ridiculous. And the jigger, basically, as we all probably know, but I'll run through it anyway, and I'll show you the setup. This will be made on shallow line. So the jigger basically runs up and down the line, like that. That's only on a short piece of line, because that jigger really is about fishing shallow. So it's probably when I'm going to somewhere like Tunnel Barn, F1 fishing, I would say mostly, but some people fish eyed, you know, when they're really crafty, when they're eyed fishing with maggots in the summer, they use a jigger and they can catch lots and lots of eyed. But simple, just some stots on there. If I drop that in my shotting tube, it basically, the shot actually just stops the float from going under. It's not overshotted. Some venues you can actually overshot on the rules. You can actually put more shot on that line than that float will take, and you just keep jiggering it up and down. It's basically, it was designed to so you can go on a venue and you're not allowed to use a bolt rig. You've got to have a float on the line. So it's a really, really, whoever come up with that idea, really, really clever, but on its day, absolutely deadly. Simple, simple fishing, and simple bulk. 4-inch hook lengths on the dibber and that float. I would have 4-inch hook lengths, not 6-inch hook lengths. So there's the jigger. Let's get him out of the way. And then one float that I've got actually got set up on my short stops is a float called an F1 shallow. I've actually got my top kits out there. Just to show you my short stops, and this is what these floats are all about. When I go to places like Tunnel Bar and I'm F1 fishing shallow, these floats have actually got a carbon stem, quite a fine bristle, but they're absolutely brilliant for fishing for F1s, whether you're fishing with pellets, casters or maggots or bits of worms, slop and things like that. They come in from 4x8 to 4x14s, and they all got their own thing on certain days. Most of the time when I'm fishing with these floats, I use 4x10s and 4x12s. These are the sort of floats where you flick around, you've got a nice fine bristle, you know, the sort of F1s, hook yourself against the elastic because you keep everything nice and tight. And that is it. That's my rig on there. I've not used these for a while because obviously we've sort of been in winter mode, and it's as simple as that. You can have these on your shortstops, in your holdall, ready to go, and you get there on the morning. And once you've gone to a venue and you've sussed out how deep you want to catch, you can actually do the rigs to the depths you want. So I can take these rigs, I might have four top kits, the same floats on, but just different depths. And I just use them hookups on there, like that. It keeps the rig on nice and tidy. That's a 4B10, and that takes four number 10 shot. And I always say, four number 10s is the perfect float for catching F1 shallow on that style of float. It always has been for me. I'm not sure why, it just works amazingly. And as you can see, I've actually got a couple of 4B12 set up as well, because that's basically got a bigger bulk. And sometimes when the F1s are really shallow, you can actually hold, it helps you hold a tight line between the elastic and the float. So the bigger float you use, shallow, you can't always catch on it, but it's worth having a couple set up, especially when you can just set them up like that. There's no hardship on the morning, you get them out, they're ready to go. But that bulk, because it's a heavier float, it keeps everything tight in that area there, from your elastic to the top of your float. So when you're missing lots of bites, sometimes put a heavier float on because it acts like a bolt rig, which catches you more fish. So that's the F1 shallow. Really, really simple. Like I said, made up, ready to go. One float, which we all know, certain times it won't be long now before these start playing a part, is the pace float. That's called a pace one. We do three different sizes in that. Fiberglass stem. So you'll probably notice between all these sort of commercial carp floats, we've changed the stems from carbon metal to fiberglass, because we all know it is mega tough, self-cocking, which helps with presentation. But the pace float comes into its own. Really, really simple. I don't mess about with light lines on these. To me, this is about catching carp. I know we catch bream, I know we catch F1s, but for me personally, it is about catching big carp with big hooks and big hook baits. And on a pace one, I've basically got four number nine stots, because I do like a little bit of shot down. One little tip is when you've plumbed up on a pace float, I normally plumb up like that. So the pace will just sort of, when you drop the pace in, you'll see the float go under and then the float comes up. But as long as it's in that area about there, where you might even see a tiny amount of the body, that's normally about right, because you need to know when the pace comes off. You don't want to be sat out there with no pace on. So just bear that in mind when you're pace fishing. But there you go, that's the pace one. They do a pace two and pace three. Obviously, they're just slightly bigger. But the pace one, we actually designed that also to fish down the edge. So we've kept the stem really short. So if you want to fish pace down the edge, or if you want to fish it shallow, which some people do, the pace one will definitely cover you. So there you go. I hope that's covered a lot of your questions and answers that we get about all the floats that I use.